First off, I want to say thank you to everybody who sent me well wishes getting over COVID. It never really hit me that hard. I was only down for a couple of days, but I do appreciate all your well wishes. So today's pattern, it is a total experiment and something that I encourage all fly tiers out there to do. After tying the Oakham Orange last week, I ended up with a handful of bright orange feather tips that I could use, and I didn't want to waste them, so I'm thinking, what kind of streamer could I come up with to use these things? And my goal here was a lightweight, almost micro streamer that I could fish with my two weight. And I did play around with adding some bucktail, even a collar hackle and some jungle cockeyes, but with every material I was adding to it, I was getting farther and farther away from, you know, it being a sleek looking streamer that I was going for. So what you're about to see here is a pretty minimalist featherwing streamer. And I do use one technique here that I like to use with a lot of featherwings, even with patterns that don't call for it, and that is to put just a little bit of bucktail in between the two feathers on top. It doesn't add that much bulk to it, but it does keep them from sticking together when they get wet, and it kind of gives you a fuller, you know, more meatier looking baitfish pattern. So there it is in the vise, what I'm going to start calling the Gunpowder Goblin. Just because it's October, nearing Halloween, and why not? So I'm tying this on a size 6. It's a 3 extra long barbless streamer hook. And I'm gonna use some black thread. I think this is a 140 denier. I'll catch it in somewhere in the middle, take it down to the bend of the hook. And for this one, I'm gonna put a tail on it, and probably doesn't even need it, but I'm just gonna take some mottled turkey slips right here. And I'm not getting fancy at all. I didn't, you know, go through all the trouble of getting a slip from a left and a right. I'm just grabbing one slip and then I split it in half and put them back to back, or concave sides together, just to get a neat little tail right there. Now it's a few wraps right here. I'm gonna snip this off because I'm gonna use a floss body and I don't want too much of a lump right here. Hopefully we can minimize that, but go ahead, just a few wraps, and then take your thread up here, somewhere close to the eye. Now I'm gonna catch you in the body material. Just, I've got about 9 or 10 inches of a standard floss right here. Let's catch it in up front, pull that back just a little bit right there. And before I wrap it back, I'm gonna go ahead and catch in my rib. And I want the silver showing, so I'm gonna catch it in with the silver side toward the hook, and this is a small. I was playing around with a medium and a larger, and I thought the small was gonna be okay. The one you saw in the vise at the beginning, it also had a small, and it's not a big flashy rib, but I think it turned out okay. Okay, and now just separate your rib from your floss, and then wrap this floss up. We're gonna go up and then halfway back down and then back up again. It might give us a little bit of a taper. That's why you need a good 9 or 10 inches. But you know what? I'm gonna need to park this tinsel out of the way with my magnet. And now we can wrap this up and back. And I'm gonna let it lay pretty flat. Just, you want at least 2 layers because this floss, it will get translucent when it gets wet, and since we're using black thread. But I'm gonna speed this up so you don't have to watch it in real time, because without using my rotary, this is probably gonna take about 2 minutes here. Okay, I told you that'd take a little while. I'm no Mike Valla. That's not a perfectly smooth body, but I think it's good enough. Now just go ahead and wrap your tinsel up, whatever you think looks good. With this size 6, I'm probably gonna get 8 or more wraps going up. Okay, I think that's enough, and we've got a decent looking body right there. Now, one thing I was playing around with was putting an underwing of bucktail, but I thought it was getting just a little bit busy. So one thing I am gonna do, I'm gonna take a standard undyed bucktail and take some of the brown fibers from the middle, just a small tuft, and I'm not gonna stack it, but I'm gonna put it in on top just to kind of get my feather wings, my feathers, a little bit of separation. So is this gonna be considered a bucktail or a feather wing? Well, I don't know. I'm gonna kind of call it a feather wing. And this bucktail is pretty sparse. It's really just to keep the feathers apart and keep them from, you know, matting together when they get wet. And since one of my goals here was to keep this thing pretty sparse and sleek, I'm only gonna put two feathers up here. You could probably sandwich it with two on each side, but I think two is gonna be just fine. I'm gonna get my length right there, and we're gonna go about right about that long there. And you can try to catch them in both at the same time, but when you're separating feathers like this, I kinda like to do them one at a time. It might make it just a little bit easier. Is that gonna be too long right there? I don't think so. I think that's gonna be about just right. So try to get your position where you want it, and a couple of loose wraps going back, and just, you know, finagle it however you like right there. And I think that's gonna be good. Now I can put a couple of tighter wraps, so hopefully it won't go anywhere on me. And we're just gonna repeat this process on the near side. And take a look at them. Are they separated enough? Maybe not. Maybe I need to adjust this one on this side and make sure I've got plenty of that bucktail in between these feathers here. Okay, I think that's close enough. Now let's snip these tips right here and just work on our streamer head. One other thing I played around with, putting some jungle cock eyes on it, and I did, but I ended up taking them off because I thought it did not add anything to it. And you know, they're pretty expensive anyway, so don't waste them on a fly that may not even need them. So go ahead and build your big head here. Now we got plenty of room for a whip finish. Take a look, see if we have any cleanup. And I don't think we have any cleanup on a sleek little micro streamer like this. Just a drop of head cement, this guy's ready to go in my box. So that's it, what I'm calling the Gunpowder Goblin. I appreciate y'all watching. Take care, and we'll see you next time.